Greetings, gamers. This week, instead of the normal review, we're going to be doing a preview roundup, where we take a look at three games that aren't even out yet, but are available thanks to Steam's Early Access program. Obviously, since these games aren't out yet, we're not going to be rating them, but we can still jump in there and have some fun and see if they're worth getting excited about. Now, the three games we're taking a look at are Mercenary Kings, Planetary Annihilation, and Interstellar Marines. If you want to skip directly to any of those games, there's links to do that in the description below. All right, let's get in there.
Cosmic obliteration for a purpose long forgotten. Technology has been captured, assimilated, refined, and transformed into brutally efficient, self-replicating mechanisms of war.
First up, let's take a look at Planetary Annihilation. If it looks familiar, that might be because you played Total Annihilation a while back, and this game is being developed by the same people. One of the things that got me curious about Planetary Annihilation is that it's one of Steam's top sellers in the Early Access program, even though it's $90 freaking. So I figure it's gotta be good if people are still buying it at that price. So I sucked it up and bought it with Ian's credit card. Anyway, the game is definitely an interesting idea. It's kind of a different take on an RTS. Instead of a closed square map like one you might see in StarCraft, you start on a planet and you can traverse all the way around the planet. And you only have a single commander at first who can build structures to harvest resources and different structures to produce units. As you build up your base, you'll eventually scout and find your enemy, and then the battle begins. One thing I don't like about this game is that there are no different factions. Everyone builds the same units. Call me old-fashioned, but I like my RTS games to have different factions so that I can be fanatically loyal to one of them. Go Terran! F*** you, Zerg and Protoss. Anyway, what this game does have, or should I say will have, is the ability to travel to different moons and planets and set up bases there, where you can launch vicious assaults on your enemies below. However, this is still the alpha build, so you can't actually do that yet. Also, the game has very few multiplayer games available on their server, even though it's one of Steam's top early access games. Basically, at this point, I think your best bet is to wait until the price drops to something more reasonable before investing in this one. Next up is Mercenary Kings. It's a game that kicks it old school, 2D side-scroller style. You play as a mercenary who is a member of the most elite fighting force on Earth. Unfortunately, all your buddies in this super elite fighting force have wound up captured by the evil organization known as Claw. And it's your job to get them back. I had a lot of fun with this one. I plugged in a controller to my PC and found that the controls were very intuitive. There's also a bunch of weapon customization, and the game allows you a good deal of freedom in choosing how you'd like to go about completing your mission. Often there are several paths to your goal, or on levels with multiple hostages, you can choose what order to save them in and use your mini-map to plot out the best course. The retro animations have a healthy dose of blood splashed in, and I have to say I do like watching enemies die in this game. The game also offers multiplayer, so you and a friend can go on a fun little murder spree together. If you're bored of all the games that are already out and feel like taking a trip down memory lane, you should probably look into getting early access to Mercenary Kings. And lastly, let's take a look at Interstellar Marines. Now, this game has something that I think every game needs: alien shark creatures with legs that can attack you on land. These things look awesome. However, they're not currently available in the early access. All that early access to this game really gets you is the chance to wander around the levels and participate in a really generic and honestly kind of lame multiplayer. Also, you can remove your helmet, which does nothing except make it slightly easier to see. There are no shark creatures, I repeat, no shark creatures anywhere in this early access. Now, if you're just looking to support the developer, by all means, go ahead and get this early access. But if you're looking for a game you can just jump into and immediately start having fun with, you might want to go with Mercenary Kings instead. Now, before any of you get in the comments and start going, "Why didn't you check out Kerbal Space Program?" Calm down, take a deep breath. I actually did get this game, but unfortunately, I have no idea what I'm doing in it. I need, like, Kerbal Space Program for Dummies or something, because my poor little astronauts are nowhere near going into orbit. This game takes some getting used to, and I may do a review or preview on it in the future, but for now, I'm still figuring it out. So, that's all for this week. If you've tried any of these games and have anything you'd like to say about them, hit the comments below. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.